has been a while since I last updated you. I have made it up to Brisbane now, and today I am at Australia's Zoo. I got here bright and early this morning. The train was at like 10 past 7, got here just before it opened at 9, and have been exploring the zoo. The sun is out today, it's really nice. I've seen so many animals already. There was wombats like just as I came in, and they were so cute. I am now walking to Africa apparently. So yeah, that's what I am up to today. See a giraffe.
He was the angriest rock you've ever seen. And so Scrap has picked up a couple of traits, but there's a movement in the water. It sets him off, he gets a bit upset. So I reckon he's all yours, Bruce. Oh, come, Bruce, get him.
Bruce, did you?
Come on, Scrap. Come on, buddy.
Yes. That wasn't a bad, half bad strike by Scrap. But when these guys mean business.
So they go to the side of the rivers and they hang out in all those reeds. And they're picking off insects and little frogs and things using his tailwalk methods. There you go. So what Scrapper does, he puts his back feet on the base of the pond, uses that big powerful tail to thrust himself up in the air. These guys have been known to catch birds on the wing, mid-fly out of the river.
Welcome to my hostel. This is bunk in Brisbane. It's nice enough. I got back from the zoo earlier. Had a really good day. I really liked it. I did find the transport quite annoying. I don't know if it's just like disruptions at the moment, but there was only like 4 trains a day like going that way. It's about an hour and a half from Brisbane on the train, which I didn't really realize. And then when I got the train up this morning, they run a like bus from the train station to the zoo. And when I went to get it back to the train station, they said that it stopped running at 3:20. But I didn't see that or hear anything about that before then. So that was a bit annoying. Luckily I managed to get on another bus to a different train station and got the train back, because I think I'd probably have had to have walked to a train station otherwise, and then the next train wasn't until like 9:30, because like I said, there was only about 4 in a day. If I'd have known this, I would have booked like a package with a transfer. I think that'd be so much easier, but I didn't. But luckily I got there and got back and had a really good day. Obviously I don't have very much room in my bag because I'm backpacking, but I did buy this little guy. I find the birds really fascinating in Australia, obviously, like compared to the ones in England. And I was looking at getting a little guy anyway, but all like the general tourist shops only have big ones of these, so I thought it was justified to get him. And then I also just got a little fridge magnet. I used to always collect snow globes growing up as my like travel souvenir, but obviously they're not very practical, So I've gone on to magnets for places that I can't get a snow globe. So I just got this one. I thought the wombats were so cute. They were one of the first ones that I saw this morning, and I thought they were so cute. So I got this little guy. I've got 2 more days in Brisbane. Tomorrow I've not got anything planned, just gonna explore the city. And then the next day I'm going to Morton Island, I think that's how you say it. I've got a trip, so you might see some of that next.
But this is where the indigenous folk lived for many, many hundreds of years. So they had a really nice little protected spot from the ocean and from the winds. So they do their fishing from the day, then come over and they clear a lot of the trees, and they never grew back. So this is where they had their home. That's just a little bit of history for you. Alrighty guys. So hopefully we've whizzing down that dune at about 50k an hour. Okay, so it's you'll be hooting along, and it's sort of, there's a big gully at the bottom and you go up the other side, so you'll be shooting up the other side probably about 50 meters, some of you. Okay, so
like that?
Yeah, like that's perfect.
Oh my god. Yeah.
Wow.
Oh my god. Bit sandy. So the first stop was sandboarding, which looks really scary from the top, but it's actually quite fun. You have to like keep your elbows up so you don't get the sand on you, and if you do that, it's pretty good. And then we're doing lunch, and then we've got kayaks and snorkeling. Such a nice day for it, so we're really lucky. Touch wood, it stays super nice, but it looks like it. Cute.
yellow fin on top. We also have the silver brim, those are the larger silver ones. Then we have the sergeant majors, those are the sort of skinnier stripy ones. And if you see like a very colourful sort of like blue, green sort of mesmerised fish, that's what we call a mooncrest fish because they're tails. We didn't see that one before. That sort of shape is shaped like a mooncrest. We also have parrotfish, don't get them confused. Parrotfish are a bit more colourful, have some more colours on them. They're here to eat away at the algae, stuff like that. Ugh. What I will get everyone.
Chicken thing.